fun. My mind's used to it.
When that alarm clock goes off, there's at least 50% of the time where you just, that soft little pillow is just caressing your head and you want to stay there. And it takes discipline to go, nope, I'm going to get up out of this bed and I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do.
We all average probably about 5 hours of sleep.
Work hard, sleep nice.
Tomorrow morning, when that alarm goes off and you start feeling all the excuses that come in, and that bed is cozy, I know what you're saying, I love my bed too. And you then go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and you get up.
That discipline that you have at that moment, you win that fight. That's a big victory. And then that pattern will carry out throughout the day. Because once you're up, well, now that I'm up, I might as well go work out because I'm already up and I feel good that I got up out of bed and I won that battle. Let me go win another battle. I'm going to go get it done. And that discipline carries on throughout the day. So now you take that and you expand that out over a week and a month, and you end up with more discipline. And it starts with that simple act of getting up and getting out of bed in the morning.
I work out twice before everyone wakes up. So it started off 4 o'clock in the morning, where I'd start with my cardio, then I'd have breakfast, and then I would go to the gym, and then I'd go to work. So I wake up at 4:30 in the morning because no one else is awake yet. So that gives me the opportunity to do things that I need to get done kind of selfishly for myself. And the big one in that category is working out. And it doesn't feel good at 4:30 when you get up, but by the time 7 o'clock rolls around and you've already worked out and you've already gotten some work done and you've got some time to say goodbye to your kids before they go to school, it's infinitely better than sleeping in until 6:45 and you get out of bed and now you missed your kids going to school or whatever. You're not prepared for the day. It's awful. Wake up at the same time every day. And if you pick that time and you start waking up at the same time every day, that's very good for you. It doesn't have to be 4:30. It could be 6:30. It could be 7. I don't know what your personal schedule is. Find out a time, pick it, set it, stick to it.
Look, everyone has a problem with time. But the day is 24 hours and we sleep 6. Now, I know there's some out there that say, whoa, I need 8. Well, I say just sleep a little faster. Because the bottom line is we have 6 hours of sleep, 24 hours are available, so you have 18 hours now available to your work, your family, your hobbies, and also to learn something new or to do something new, which could easily be that you want to learn a new language, to read a book every week, or you say, I'm going to go and reshape my body. So you're going to go and take this hour out of your schedule and say, I'm going to train an hour every day. So this is, for most people, a huge challenge, but it is totally doable, I can tell them. Because the kind of things that I did when I came to this country, I mean, I went to school, I was working in construction, I was working out my 5 hours a day, I was taking acting classes from 8 o'clock at night to 12 midnight. I was doing all of those things. I wanted to make sure that out of the 24 hours of the day, that I don't waste one single hour. Those hours were too precious. And so there I just want to tell people, don't give me this thing, I have a difficult time with the time and I don't have time for this and I don't have that. You have time. You make the time.
Sometimes, even if you're the most highly motivated person in the world, that grind starts to beat you down a little bit. And that's when you have to stop looking at the short-term thing, because that's not getting you to get it done. And you got to look, okay, what is the long-term goal that I'm looking at? What am I really trying to get done in the long term? And you say, oh, you know what? I'm actually waking up today early so I can be ahead of the curve, so I can sell more of these widgets or whatever, so that I can buy a house. And you know what? Today matters. Today matters. This decision that I'm making right now is that first step. It's me taking one stroke, swimming in the right direction, heading towards the shore. And if I don't take this, I'm not making any progress.
I've been struggling. We still had all the same problems. We still had a lien on the house, still facing bankruptcy, still fighting like crazy. I was still unemployed. The next morning, the alarm goes off, and I pretended NASA was there. It's the stupidest story. I literally went 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I counted out loud, and then I stood up. And I'll never forget standing there, and for the first time in 3 months, I had beaten my habit of hitting the snooze button. I couldn't believe it, and I thought, wait a minute. Counting backwards, that is the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my entire life. Well, the next morning I used it again and it worked. The next morning I used it again and it worked. The next morning I used it again and it worked. And then I started to notice something really interesting. There were moments all day long. All day long. Just like that 5-second moment in bed. Where I knew knowledge what I should do. And if I didn't move within 5 seconds, my brain would step in and talk me out of it. Every human being has a 5 second window, might even be shorter for you. You have about a 5 second window in which you can move from idea to action before your brain kicks into full gear and sabotages any change in behavior. Because remember, your brain is wired to stop you from doing things that are uncomfortable or uncertain or scary. It's your job to learn how to move from those ideas that could change everything into acting on them in the smallest moment.
They have no magic to stir men's blood. Make large plans, for they do have magic to stir men's blood.
Impossible is not a fact, it's an opinion. It's your opinion, and they'll say, no, science shows. And I say, yeah, and how many times has science shown something's impossible, now science shows it's possible. Things are impossible until somebody does it. Divorce the story of your limitation and marry the truth of your unlimited capacity, then the whole game changes.
Success is born out of luck. It's awareness of mind that takes advantage of that opportunity. You will all be confronted with opportunity. You must take advantage of it. Because if you don't take advantage of your opportunity, you'll never realize your dreams. Whether you want them or not is the irrelevance. You don't know that until you achieve it.
But most people have strategies available, or they could get them, or you could create them. But the problem is you got a story. And your story is why it isn't working. And the story is, I've tried everything. If you tried everything, you'd be fit. If you tried everything, you'd be profitable. If you tried everything, you'd be there. But people say it.
I was born onto a couch to stay. Getting a job at the Hotel St. George was my passport to escape the world that I was born into, to start a new world. Do I have what it takes? I said to myself, yes. So I started pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing. It's about self-belief at whatever cost.
You can do more than this. If I had to walk, I had to walk. It just became just a process of grinding and grinding, and grinding is not even a good word for it. It's not even a good word for it. And just going further and further. And then when I got through running, I go to the bike, I go to the pool. If I got tired somewhere, my legs are tired, I go to the gym. And I developed this crazy workout where I was doing volume.
Things don't happen overnight. You have to make the emotional and the personal investment to make your dreams come true. Never throw in the towel. And if I throw in the towel, pick it up. Never give in. Never, ever, ever give in. And when you're young, it's very easy to give in, to walk away. It really is. So whatever you want to do in your life, don't overwork it, don't overthink it, and you'll realize your dream. Trust me.
The question isn't, can you handle the situation? The question is, can you handle your mind? Can you manage the thoughts and the emotions that are trying to poison your progress? Forget managing the situation. Manage your mind.